making a video showing everybody how I extend the life of the IQAir filters, because the ceiling filter is excellent, but the filters are very, very expensive to replace. It has a filter indicator, a change indicator on it, but that is just a predetermined number saying that the filters have so many hours. But in reality, it depends upon the environment that you're using it in. If you're using it in a really dirty environment, then filters will be clogged faster. If it's a cleaner environment, it'll take longer. It depends how much you use it and how dirty the air is. So it's hard to really go by that number. The first thing I do to extend the life of my filters is I add a pre-filter. I add this stuff to the bottom of it. This is called a Filtreat. It's electrostatically charged hammock filters for air conditioners or whatever. Really thin stuff. I just cut it to the same shape as the IQAir filter and tape it to the bottom. There's different brands of it. This is a desktop, or you could even use the carbon stuff, that thin generic carbon pre-filter stuff, and cut it to size and just tape it to the bottom. And I'll show you how I did that. Okay, here's the bottom of it. All I did is I taped it basically to the bottom before I put the pre-filter in, just loosely taped it. And here it is, this will pre-filter that filter. One note about that, when the pre-max filter starts getting to be older, say you've pre-filtered it like several times and it's starting to get to be older and you're going to be replacing it soon, then there's no point pre-filtering for that one last time. So say you use the pre-filter three times, it's all dirty three times, and then you don't bother using a pre-filter anymore, just use the pre-max that it came with. Then when that gets dirty, then replace it. You follow? Anyway, when you're changing this thing, take, like I said, with all wear cleaners, take it outside. Be very careful, or if you handle this rough, you're going to get lots of dirt coming back into your air. So do it outside, or can if you can, or in your garage or whatever. And just always handle filters and pre-filters very carefully. So that's one way that I extend the life of my IQAir filters, and I'll show you my next way here. Okay, one more thing to add for extending the life of your filters. When you're changing the this extra pre-filter that I put on, or even if you don't want to bother with that, what you can do is you can take a vacuum and you can just very gently, on low suction, vacuum out the bottom of the pre-max filter to get all the large dirt out. Don't try to force all the dirt out. That's not the idea. You're just trying to get the loose big stuff. And only do that if you have a good vacuum, like a sealed HEPA vacuum. This is a Mio S5. Use a similar type vacuum to do that. If you just have a cheap vacuum, don't do that, or you'll be just recirculating the microscopic dust. That's one little note about that. Okay, the next thing I did is I found a way to basically pre-filter the IQAir totally with another air cleaner. And all I did to do is I made this platform to put the IQAir on. It's very simple. Just made it as simple as I can, just out of a 1x2s there. And it's 20 inches high, 20 inches across, and 16 like that. See, it's very simply designed. All it's going to do is support the IQAir. I'm going to put the IQAir on top of here. So it's going to be sucking air from right here. And then I have this other Honeywell air cleaner here, 17450. You can use any one. Any air cleaner you can, even use a homemade one that I made would work too. Just any cheaper one, because I got a whole bunch of these filters and I can get them for cheap. And it pushes the air up. So all you have to do is, I built it to basically fit this air cleaner. It would fit most of them. All I do is I put the other air cleaner underneath like that, and I would turn it on, and it would blow air up into the bottom of the IQAir like so. And it would basically, there's a HEPA filter in here, but it's not as efficient. It's not as efficient as the one in the IQAir. The IQAir filters down to less than 0.1 of a micron, the ultrafine particles, where I don't think this one is nearly as good. This one actually does leak some 0.5 micron particles. I think the reason for that is, if I take this off, this is the cover. I gotta change that filter. As you can see here, there's no gasket on this filter. It's just hard plastic right here. And this is hard plastic right here. So basically, there's no real airtight seal on this design, because it just goes in there. Sorry about this. One hand. basically just goes in there and screws in this plastic against plastic. Some of the Honeywell filters have kind of a rubberish gasket around there to make a better seal. But even the filter itself leaks a bit. It's not perfect, it's pretty good. Not nearly as good as the IQAir. IQAir reads zero or one particle counter. Just an amazing machine. But this is a great way if you have an extra old cleaner, air cleaner kicking around, to pre-filter your IQAir, and your filters will last much longer. And I'll just prop it on here and show you what it looks like. Okay, here's what it looks like on the stand I built. Here's the IQAir. This is a compact version. It's on top of the this wooden frame that I built. Very simple wooden frame. You can get fancier if you want. If you want to get fancier, you can make a bottom. You can make a bottom to it and then put casters on it and have wheels and then maybe put some metal brackets on here so it won't tip over to stabilize it a little more. But I just wanted to make it simple for now and make a better one. But there you see, it's just the air cleaner that goes underneath. And all I would do is I'll turn that one on and this one on too. So I'll put this one on. And you kind of want to match the power. This one has three settings. You'll kind of want to match whatever the suction is approximately. In other words, you don't want to blow this one full steam and have this on low power, because then you might be blowing some dust off of the bottom of this filter on the IQAir. You don't want to do that. So you want to have this filter blowing pretty close to what this is sucking in. Generally, I put this on like medium. There we go. So this one's on medium right now. I'll put the IQAir usually on level 5. My favorite level for it, because it's almost full power at 6 levels. Here we go. There's 6. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Find the noise level is not too bad on 5, but when you go to level 6 full power, it's way louder. So anyway, right now it's double filtering the IQAir, and this has a CPZ carbon filter inside the HEPA filter to remove some gases and odors. But there you go, blowing quite a bit of air actually, right up. See that? And that basically pre-filters the IQAir really well, and that will be the cleanest air you can possibly get. You may think this is a little redundant, and I guess in some ways it is, but it for sure it will extend that life of that HEPA filter. Because I got lots of filters for these, and you can get them pretty cheap. I got tons of them, and they're way cheaper than the IQAir ones. And like I said, this one does leak 0.5 micron particles. I don't have a 0.3 counter yet. I'm going to get one soon. But this one doesn't leak any. I have my 0.5 counter here. It's a Dylos DC1700. 0.5 microns on the left, 2.5 on the right. See where our ambient count is. Have my air cleaners blowing most of the day, so they're pretty low. They're in excellent range. Excellent is 75 and under. Very poor is 3,000 plus. Okay, we'll put it. There's the input, there's the output. Like I say, this isn't the best counter to do this, but we'll watch the counts. And they go to zero. They always stay 0.5 microns on this thing. Even without the double filtering, it still does. And this Honeywell one doesn't quite do that. Pull it out here. And this counter is not the best for this because it doesn't have a pump, but I'm going to get one of those soon. I'll put it on here. And I'm forcing air in this counter, so this is not really accurate at all. I think this this grill is actually getting backflow. Some of the air is actually kind of backflowing in the corners and coming right back out. And also, I think there is a slight design flaw with this Honeywell particular unit, because it has the gas absorbing CPZ cartridge, the carbon filter, in the center. So basically it pulls air through the edges, through the center. I think potentially, I think it's better to have the carbon filter, the thicker carbon filter, on the outside. So I think what could be happening here is it could be pulling some carbon dust from the carbon filter and then putting it out here. I think that's a possibility. But anyway, it sure collects a lot of dust on this thing. This thing gets totally white after a while. I'm gonna change it. But there you have it. The best way to make your filter last a lot longer. And there's the particle counts once more. And another plus for this, the way I have this, since you're blowing air up into the IQAir, it will make less resistance and probably make the IQAir's motor work a little less hard. And you actually might get a little extra airflow coming out to the top. So that's probably one side effect is the IQAir motor won't work as hard. And another little interesting side note about the IQAirs is they do tend to make a lot of heat. All motors do, but I guess this one has to work pretty hard to pull through the two thick filters. But I definitely notice when I have my two IQAirs on full power, the room actually gets warmer. So just an interesting note. They do draw a fair bit of power. All right. Yeah, one more comment about the stand here, why it's a good idea. I know this particular model of IQAir comes with these casters that you go on the bottom, and it does elevate it off the floor a little bit. But you see here, this is highly elevated off the floor, and that's really good because it just gives it less resistance. It gives it full pull with nothing getting in the way at all. And also, I don't really want this pulling air directly from my carpeting right there. It's brand new carpeting, it might be off-gassing still. So I don't really want this close to the carpet sucking, you know, new carpet smell from the carpet. Does that make sense? And I do have another air cleaning thing here. This is my IQAir clean room. And also I pre-filtered that. I'm going to be making another stand for this one. But right now, for summertime, it's actually fall. But I have this little gizmo. I made another video. I pull air from outside into this box. I have a homemade HEPA filter inside the box, basically a fan there, pulls it into the box, cleans it, and puts it right to the bottom of this IQAir and puts it out. That's the way of getting fresh air from outside in. But it also pre-filters this IQAir as well to make it last longer, because this is a clean room H13 IQAir, and those filters are even more expensive than the Health Pro ones. So feel free to leave some comments if you need any more advice, or if you have some for me, or any suggestions, or if you want to see any more tests with the particle counter.